Dear all, in this lecture video, I'll be discussing about piezoelectric transducer. In order to get the previous video, please click on the I button on the right top of the particular video. Actually, I have covered the following topics. Right now, I'm going to cover the piezoelectric transducer. Okay. Now let us understand the technical details about piezoelectric transducer. What do you mean by piezoelectric transducer? What are the peculiarities of piezoelectric transducer? In fact, the piezoelectric transducer is an electroacoustic transducer used for conversion of pressure or mechanical stress into alternating electrical force. That means pressure and mechanical stress, etc., are called non-electrical quantity. That is going to convert into electrical force by using the piezoelectric effect. It's applicable only for certain type of crystals, not for all the type of solid material. The piezoelectric transducer converts the physical quantity into an electrical voltage, which is easily measured by any kind of voltage measuring technique such as analog or digital methods. So this is the way how piezoelectric crystal or piezoelectric transducer can be operated. Moving on to the further discussions, I have collected few more information about piezoelectric crystal. Moving on to the definition. When mechanical force or stress is applied to some material such as piezoelectric material or piezoelectric crystal, along certain plane, they produce electric voltage. Okay, you need to apply the non-electrical quantity such as mechanical force or stress in a particular axis of a material. That material is having speciality. It's not like a common material that I will be discussing later on. Then that material can able to produce electric voltage. This electric voltage can measure by using voltage measuring instruments. Either it may be analog or digital. Now, what is the working principle of piezoelectric transducer? The working principle of piezoelectric transducer is piezoelectric effect. What do you mean by piezoelectric effect? If the varying potential is applied to the proper axis of the crystal, it will change the dimension of the crystal and thereby deformation will be taken place on the crystal. Due to that deformation, the electricity will be generated across another point. That phenomenon is generally known as piezoelectric effect. Okay, so in parallel to the deformation, electrical voltage will be generated. How the deformation will be taken place? Because of your application of mechanical stress or pressure or force, whatever it may be. So in parallel, electrical voltage will be generated. That voltage can be measured by using either analog or digital methods. I would like to show you a schematic diagram of piezoelectric transducer. So piezoelectric crystal, that is the main component of piezoelectric transducer. You can look at the piezoelectric crystal and we are having upper as well as lower surfaces. So we consider these are the two electrodes. You are going to apply force or pressure or stress, whatever it may be here. So because of that, the deformation will be taken place inside the material. Due to the deformation, the output voltage will be generated. This is because of piezoelectric effect. It's applicable only for certain kind of salts like Rochelle salt, then quartz crystal, etc. That I will be telling you later on. I'll be explaining thereafter. So this is the schematic diagram of piezoelectric transducer. You are applying the force over here. In parallel, you will be getting the electrical voltage. Okay, here deformation will be taken place over the crystal. Another diagram which depicts the operation of piezoelectric transducer. We have the piezoelectric crystal. Here you are applying the stress. You can able to see stress is applying over there. These are the area where you are going to provide the stress. In parallel, deformation will be taken place over the material. Where is the material? You can see this is your material. Due to the deformation, what is going to happen? The voltage. So voltage will be generated in the meter. So that is very clear in case of piezoelectric transducer. This is the way how piezoelectric transducer is getting operated. Okay. In practical cases, you can able to see, this is one of the practical cases I have taken from the Google image. And this is the way how piezoelectric crystal look like. Okay, likewise, there are a lot of images that I will try to put up at the end. Okay, so this is the way how piezoelectric crystal look like. These are the two electrodes. You are going to provide the stress across the electrode. In parallel, electricity will be generated. So these are the two electrodes. One is over here, other will be at the opposite side. And these are the two terminals. Can you able to see the terminals? Okay, these are the two terminals, terminal one and terminal two. Okay, this is electrode one. electrode 2 will be at the opposite side. So you are applying the high pressure or force, whatever it may be. So what is going to happen? So electrical voltage that will come across 1 and 2, red and the black terminal you can able to see. That means V12, voltage will be generated across the terminal. So this is the way how a piezoelectric transducer is getting operated. Hope the diagram is very clear to you. What are the examples of piezoelectric crystals? Rochelle salt, ammonium dehydration, phosphate, then lithium phosphate, potassium tetrate, ceramic material. These are the different type of piezoelectric crystal. This can be used in piezoelectric transducer. Let me ask one more question. How do you classify piezoelectric crystal? What are the taxonomy? How do you classify the piezoelectric crystal? Actually, there are two types of piezoelectric crystal. Depends on the availability. Is it synthetic or natural? Okay, according to synthetic or natural. So if I talk about the natural type of crystal, one of the best example is quartz crystal. So you can use the quartz as a piezoelectric material or piezoelectric transducer. Moving on to the second part, that is a synthetic crystal. You can able to observe Rochelle salt, lithium sulfate. These are the examples of synthetic crystal. Okay, this is the classification of piezoelectric crystal. You can remember these points and you can able to remember the various examples of piezoelectric crystal. You can able to identify the market availability as well. What are the desirable properties of piezoelectric crystal? It should have stability. That is very important. And it should show high output. And intensity to temperature and humidity. Insensitivity. Okay, not intensity. Insensitivity to temperature and humidity. That is another crucial important factor which should have been included in the piezoelectric crystal. And ability to form desired shape. Okay, because of changes in shape, you will be getting the output voltage. It should have proper criteria to deform the shape. That is another peculiarity of piezoelectric transducer. Okay, these are the desirable property of piezoelectric crystal. While purchasing, you should take care of all the parameters. So I would like to show you the mathematical expression which is related to piezoelectric crystal. You can able to see the equation, the EMF or output voltage that is given by G into T into F by L. Look at the first equation. What is G? G is nothing but the voltage sensitivity in terms of Vm per Newton. Okay, that is the voltage sensitivity. Then what do you mean by T? T is nothing but thickness of the crystal. And we can able to say that G, what do you mean by G? Voltage sensitivity, I already explained. Then F is nothing but force, applied force. You are applying the non-electrical quantity. For example, force or stress or whatever it can be. That is denoted by F. Then A means area of the crystal in meter square. Area, total area of the crystal in meter square. And one more thing, you know that force by area is equal to pressure. Okay, it is very clear. Force by area is equal to pressure. Now do one thing. The equation is equal to G into T into F upon A. So you can do one thing. GT can be clubbed together and F by A can be make out together. This way can you able to write? Of course, it is possible, right? So what you can do? What is F by A? So F by A is nothing but, see, F by A is nothing but pressure, force by area. This is the ratio of force by area. So the final answer is GTP. So this is the final answer. I think you can concentrate this equation. Okay, GTP. That means the EMF, which is produced across the piezoelectric transducer, that is directly proportional to pressure, then voltage sensitivity and thickness of the material. Okay, so E is directly proportional to P, T and G. That you can write separately. Here you can able to see K1 terminology. What is G? They are deep, you can able to see the definition of G. G is nothing but piezoelectric constant to the thickness of the crystal. It varies upon different type of crystal. Which type of crystal you are going to employ, that varies. That point also you can note down. Okay, so this is the mathematical expression which is very important for solving the numerical example. Okay, you can remember. I'll be putting the numerical example in the upcoming sessions. Kindly follow up. Definitely you have to recall these equations whenever I'm going to explain the numerical example. What are the major applications of piezoelectric transducer? It is mainly used in microphones. In case of microphone, the sound pressure is converted into electrical signal. That is very clear. And ultimately, it is amplified to produce the loud sound. Okay, that will be taken place. Then medical diagnosis, biomedical applications, and also it is used in electric lighter in kitchens. That is quite formula. that is quite familiar and you can able to verify. There is a small type of crystal which is available. That is basically a quartz crystal or any type of piezoelectric material. So what is happening here? The pressure made on the piezoelectric sensor will create the electrical signal, which is ultimately causes the flash or fire up. Then inkjet printers, that is another application. Toys. Okay, toys where the children used to put on shoes and all, you can able to observe. Whenever they are walking, there may be production of light. So that is also another example of piezoelectric crystal. So piezoelectric crystals have been included in their particular shoes. Whenever child is applying pressure over the shoes, definitely electrical voltage is getting generated. So because of the potential difference, there will be movement of flow of electrons. Due to that, there is a formation of light. It is also used in restaurants or airport where a person steps near to the door and the door open automatically. Okay, that is also another important information. Then landline phones, it can be used in landline phones, and it is also used in seismograph. Okay, different researchers, many people are doing the research on vibration, rocks, etc. Seismography, one of the major branch of science. And this can be employed in ultrasonic imaging in biomedical applications. These are the few applications of piezoelectric crystal. The contribution of piezoelectric crystal in the area of sensors and transducer is highly unavoidable. Okay, it is actually highly respectable. What are the major advantages of piezoelectric crystal? It is an active transducer, no need for any external, excitation. Easy to handle and use it as a small dimension and a high frequency response. It means that parameters changes with rapidly. If you plot the frequency domain specification, if you compute the frequency domain specification, you will be able to get the proper values like bandwidth, the cutoff frequency, everything will be in a proper manner, in a proper range, so that it shows better frequency response. What are the major drawbacks of piezoelectric transducer? It is not suitable for measurement of static condition, only suitable for measurement in the dynamic condition and the temperature effects. Okay, it changes the reading, then the output is low, so external circuit is attached. So for the amplification, actually the output which is generating from the piezoelectric transducer, that is very less. To enhance that particular signal, okay, to extract the signal, we require special type of amplifier that is expensive, and the maintenance of that kind of amplifier circuit, auxiliary circuit, that is quite expensive. It is very difficult to give the desired shape to the material and desired strength. As I told you that deformation matters a lot in case of piezoelectric transducer. To providing the suitable shape and size, everything is somewhat complex. Okay, these are the few things you have to remember regarding the cons of the piezoelectric transducer. As you know that for every system there will be pros and cons. In this session, I have discussed about what do you mean by piezoelectric crystal. Thereafter, what is a piezoelectric effect and how does piezoelectric crystal operate? Afterwards, I have shown one schematic diagram and how it practically look. Thereafter, I have explained the taxonomy of piezoelectric transducer. In the sense, how do you classify the piezoelectric transducer? At the end, I have discussed about advantages, disadvantages, and applications. The contribution towards sensors and transducer is very essential, and we can able to understand the importance of piezoelectric crystal in the area of sensors and transducer. Hope the session is useful to you. In the upcoming session, I'll be discussing about thermoelectric transducer. Finally, thank you for watching.